hear it for our readers. Thanks for being here. Forgiveness. 100 tourists are caught in my throat, trying to speak the tones with which you stroke. Red, I love you sorely. Gold, I am not good enough to leave her for. Copper, I am your long offering, your secret wifeless bride. White, I know your body only as its shadow. You do not know mine. Silver, I will never take your last name. Black, blackness. You, master of the plastered crack and seam, master of a natural disaster's epiphany. Master of coral, ash, cream, and river brain. Master of the century. Master of man. I want to be more than the loyal sorter of your oils, the soiled dress you press against a bookshelf of bound metaphors, our clasped gasps shaking those spines from their nests, all the larkins above us falling to their deaths. We should have been amongst the greats. We could have been up there. Dear Philip, I ask the poet in you, what is worse, being in love with someone you can't have, or being in love with someone you can only in secret? I want you to read not just the subtext of my flesh. I want you to read more than just between the lines, between my legs, unbeknownst to that blonde dawn who rises daily from your sheets, her ceaseless love always beating me from the east. I want to have you like Warhol's cell to warlords, like Balthazar had a bucket list. But I know there will be no ending to the suffered coveting. Her body is yours, and your body is ours, and mine is nobody's. So forgive me, master. To the screaming waves you conjure, I imagine you losing her. Forgive me. The flat across the street is on fire, and I want to save no one. Forgive me. Herod should have written Europa the poem that showed her no mercy. Forgive me. Browning should have prepared for the hell of infinity when she began to count the ways she loved thee. Forgive me. I want back those passwords that sprung encrypted from your lips into my lungs. I hereby reverse the cursed worshipping of a coffin built for two. Buried half true, I have forgotten you. I do not remember the smell of your turpentine neckline, your kerosene scent carried through the vents like heroin in a forearm's dent. We never met. I did not let you sleep on the moving sheets of my silver screens. There were no second thoughts. I was never your one of a kind. I did not write your name on my father's arms. I did not want to know your daughter and son. I did not think about bearing you another one. I did not let your legendary thumbs touch the tips of my unsung ones. I did not come. Your voice was not a soundtrack for my blood. Your voice could not make me die forever. Your voice. There was never a first kiss. Regardless, you were not guilty. You thought only of her forever. It did not touch me. I was safe. I did protect myself. The scar was so small. I was not a drifting ship dipping into tortured clouds. I did not look at my empty hands and think of white wolves dying in the snow. There were no other women besides her. She does deserve you. She is worthy of your hands. She... I did not think cruel things. I was not ashamed. I will be forgiven. I never told you I loved you. You did say you did too. I do not remember. We did say goodbye. We did finish this. Our bodies never brought us up again, nor did our pens. Red, I loved you. Gold, I was not good enough. Copper, your secret. White, your body, not mine. Silver, she'll take your last name. Black. 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 I repeat the needed mantra like opera needs sonata. I am your coda, etc. The life I will never have with you will forever be the life I will have with you. The life I will never have with you will forever be the life I will have with you. The life I will never have with you will forever be the life I will have with you. And